North of London, things get a little less hectic. As my friend Ladina puts it, you go to London. You don't stay in London. I sit down. And I couldn't agree more. If you're looking for somewhere quieter and a bit more picturesque, St. Albans is for you. St. Albans prides itself on their patron saint and cathedral, the oldest in all of England. So proud, in fact, there's a whole day dedicated to it, with parades and markets and street dancers on hand to celebrate. An entire weekend devoted to 1,700 years of history, which includes a pretty gruesome retelling of Mr. Albans' demise.
Like, seriously, God, if you're going to prioritize how to save Alban, maybe just save him from death rather than just give him a glass of water. But maybe because he had two miracles, that's why he's saved.
Things might not have worked out with the saint himself, but this community thrives on its rich culture and quintessentially English architecture. Aaron and Ladina Rees own a consulting firm that specializes in creativity.
It would make sense if I introduce the session in general.
But what I do for my work is I try and help people to understand what creativity really is.
But in terms of actually coaching them from creating the art,
right,
that certainly should fall to you.
Right, that's what I was thinking.
I'm an artist and I paint circles.
Sabretooth Panda helps companies and individuals find their own creative spirit.
What it is we are interested in is showing people the relationship between imperfection and beauty and creativity, because it's in those imperfections you find opportunity for creativity, and we are going to then explore that through people drawing and creating patterns and shapes and images within their end zone.
They inspire groups to base their lives and their livelihoods on being more creative.
And then just to encourage them that what they're doing is the right choice. Just questions that get their mind starting to think about their life and what's important to them. Because what happens a lot in creativity is people just doubt themselves, and they don't feel that they have the skill to be creative without recognizing that it doesn't actually take skill. It's more like letting the expression come out.
And so somebody says, well, I'm an accountant, therefore I'm not creative at all. I'm probably one of the most creative people.
Is your business lacking that special spark? Call in these two to bring a fresh vision to your pursuits. What better way to forward your goals than through a combination of work and play?
So
I will explain why we're doing what we're doing, the reason we designed it this way, and the meaning of it. How this relates to what 72 Panda is all about.
Enter Sunrise and Trestle. Two organizations close in proximity, yet undeniably worlds apart.
Yeah, I think I'm Jane Harris. I work at Sunrise Senior Living in Bagshot.
Hi, Jane.
Sunrise Elderly Care Center is a grand and lively house. Residents and staff look forward to daily activities like you would on a cruise, a pressure I was perhaps underprepared for. These were no slouches in the art department. I could only hope they would enjoy me waxing poetic about circles and play along while I was there.
Circles are fascinating to me. I think so much of life can be explained just in a circle.
I didn't have to wait very long. They were off, drawing and coloring like they did this for a living.
That is fantastic!
When at first they asked, why circles, why this?
The Enzo itself is necessarily imperfect.
The Enzo circle is considered the fingerprint of the artist who created it. This is a circle that's supposed to be a reflection of you and your life.
At Sunrise, they valued memories, making drawings that reflected their lifetime of experiences. Some memories brought joy and laughter.
This is
this water is all the affection I've received in my life. All the kisses, the hugs, all the handicrafts, like flowers, I've received a lot of affection.
All the kisses?
Yes.
Oh, that's lovely.
And my knitting, and I put some kosher hooks in.
Others' sadness and regret.
It makes me homesick to do that.
But she said, it makes me homesick now and makes me sad. So I don't want to work on this one anymore. I don't want to look at this one anymore. So I said that
even arts that make us sad are beautiful.
The good news is, though, in that sadness, she has such a beautiful memory of this place. She said, oh, that's true, I guess. That's a good way to look at it. I was humbled that they were comfortable sharing their lives with me.
What you got with the elderly people at Sunrise was a lot more introspection. A lot of reminiscing, a lot of nostalgia, perhaps. What we were trying to do was provide some autonomy. So what creativity does is it gives you choices.
Because the more creative you can be, the more ideas you can come up with, the more options you have in front of you, the more control you can have over your life. So this is why I think it's very important for everyone at every stage in life to indulge yourself in creativity.
With fewer choices, you can start to feel like you're not in control of your life. What creativity can do is help you see that whatever is there, it's yours to make something of.
A lot of them turned up to the session not knowing what they were going to do, resistant to the activity, heard the word creativity shut down, and were like, I can't do anything. And they were almost paralysed themselves in their own thoughts. And for me, what I loved seeing was them, through the activity and the play elements of this, that they were able to break down their own personal barriers and find that expression, find that creativity within them. And you saw how much it just changed their minds, it changed their mindset, their view of what they were doing, and they got excited. Mm-hmm. And it was the joy of it, because the way we did it was through play, and it made it easier to access their creativity.
Seeing their experiences accumulate over life and how that changed them as human beings, I found that so incredible and so inspiring to myself as a person, and realizing how much I will probably change as I grow older.
For me, most interesting was the gentleman who spoke to us afterwards. He used to be an artist.
He was an artist. And
he had a stroke. We had no idea beforehand. But he said to us afterwards that he hadn't picked up a pen or a pencil in years.
And it's been years since he's picked up a brush.
And this had taken away from him this form of expression, this way of relating to the world, which he'd always used. Because we'd offer him something simple, he felt confident enough to try.
But then he came up to each and every one of us to thank us. And he
came up to us all and thanked us all individually afterwards.
And just, thank you so much for having this. And this was really great. What an experience.
So I'm the artistic director of Trestle Theatre Company, and we're mask and physical theatre practitioners. And we've paired up with Sabretooth Panda. There's a lovely harmony to be found there.
Part theatre, part art school, Trestle Art Space brought a whole new standard of creative activities to entertain and educate their students.
So for Trestle, it's all about getting up and being creative and being dramatic and the performing arts and just kind of releasing creativity.
Young people at Trestle, what we're hoping to do with them is help them begin early in their lives with ideas about creativity which are more useful. And we're trying to help them deal with what's coming next.
The great skill that Sabretooth Panda have is to then take that creativity and relate it to people's everyday behaviours and patterns.
So for Trestle, they were very good with play, but when they went to draw, they felt there were rules and wanted approval. I was surprised at how self-conscious they were. I thought kids would have no fear about anything, that they were the ones comfortable with who they are.
I wasn't sure what to do, and I just did something, and then...
Yet they were concerned about doing something wrong and annoyed at their imperfections.
All of mine just failed. Okay, well then...
They seemed shy to approach the subject and critical of their process. They were familiar with play, they were familiar with drawing, but they still brought in these internal rules, and it was helping them break that down, which was really exciting for me. But kids don't need much help. Markers? Check. Paper? Got you covered. And my directions were pretty simple. make whatever you want.
But it's okay if you're not happy with it. It's okay, actually. That's part of the lesson today. So, I want you to look at the circle you have in front of you. I want you to look at
the pumpkin around you.
There you go, that's exactly what I was going to say. Find out, what does it look like to you? That none of these are perfect circles.
It looks like a potato.
That's a potato? Anybody else? Okay, we've got an egg over here. Any other words? Yeah, we've got an egg, a potato, a pumpkin. Onion. Okay.
Seeing that release for them, that they didn't have rules to constrain them at that moment, that they could turn it into anything they wanted, or a monster or anything. So that release is a different level for them that they were familiar with.
Yeah, play. Well, the thing that I thought was funny is, as you're saying, play is so much easier for kids in theory. And when they came in, I thought for sure that this would be so easy for them. But they came in with more self-consciousness than I realized and weren't quite sure what they were supposed to do. And when they began, some of them were so critical of themselves and they were saying, this is rubbish, this isn't right.
What's rubbish about it?
Really unhappy with it when we talked about that.
Okay, so. No, you tell me that's rubbish. Okay,
what's that? Apple.
Let's have a look.
It's like an apple.
You reckon this is rubbish? What are you saying?
Yeah.
Why is it rubbish?
It's like an apple.
How wobbly it was. How.
Because it's not another circle?
Why did you think it was rubbish?
Just didn't think it was a proper circle. Like
why not?
Because it just. Was where it had loads of wobbly bits.
A little wobbly and things like that.
It doesn't look like a circle.
Yeah, it does. It was like a face.
It was like a face?
Or a paper.
Okay.
An apple!
Now, interesting that you say that it's rubbish, because I think that might be the best one we've got here. I'm going to tell you why.
When you took the negative assumption that the imperfections are bad, that there is a correct way that things should be, and then there is bad, there's imperfections and mistakes. If you take that and reframe it and say, okay, what if imperfections are potential? What if imperfections and struggle and challenges are actually not just unavoidable, but necessary?
We're going to do an exercise next, working on the imperfections of these circles. Everyone tell me what an imperfection is. I went up, I saw that. Anyone else? What's the
imperfection? You have like bits of yourself, like you have thoughts and stuff that isn't perfect about yourself.
Faults, anything else? So, something that's perfect, absolutely faultless, is also really boring.
Yeah, a perfect circle is boring, right? It's exactly so.
Exactly. Imperfections. Things that make things unique. And the same way as this circle down here, which you tend to rub it, I see all the little wobbly bits and the little wobbly bits around the edge as opportunities to do something really interesting. But a perfect circle gives you nothing in terms of interesting little wobbly bits around the edge to work with. It's just smooth and flat and boring, whereas a wobbly circle like this one gives you an opportunity to do something interesting. And that is what we're going to do in the next part.
The fact that it was so wobbly and uneven actually made it really interesting. And he ended up drawing a gigantic rhino and with another rhino inside it and another rhino inside that. And that was, well, obviously completely unpredictable, but also embracing, well, rhinos are pretty knobbly creatures, right? So. As soon as you look at this circle, go, okay, what is this circle? What is it? What does it have? And see those things as places to move on from.
Well, it was a rhino. It's a rhino. So it was a little rhino in here.
Yeah.
And then I thought extending the rhino into a whole circle and putting another circle into an even bigger rhino. That's and then just thought about what other ideas were.
As soon as we did that, the young people in the group changed their responses quite quickly. they were willing to let go of something they felt very certain about just a few minutes earlier. And that is in essence what creativity is. Seeing something, asking a question of it, and then changing what you think of it. We used to think it was this, now we think it's that, and now because we've changed, there's something new. And that was really enjoyable because of how quickly it happened.
It took some coaxing, but soon everyone realized there really were no wrong answers. For some, it was an easy task. Their favorite things were Wi-Fi, cartwheels, and Pokemon.
What did you think Pikachu today?
I just did yellow around it and then just jumped on me.
Because it looked like a Pikachu. What made you come up with these lines right here?
Wi-Fi.
I totally love that. That's the cutest part now. I didn't know. Oh, that's pretty brilliant. You like Wi-Fi at home? Is that your favorite thing?
Yeah. Oh, you did do an Instagram.
The Wi-Fi bar. The Wi-Fi and the Instagram, I think, are close to my heart. Yeah.
Others had a grander vision in mind, an eye for the bigger picture.
Being able to watch them take what they felt like they were doing wrong and then completely blow that away and realize that they could turn it into anything that they wanted to, anything that they thought of, and what they came up with was in itself the beauty and the fun of it. That's what made me really happy, is to see the happiness on all of their faces at the end of it. They just seemed so thrilled with what they'd accomplished.
Afterwards, each had thoughtful, sometimes enlightened explanations behind their creations.
I think it's an expression, like the windows to yourself. I really like that.
They'd written intricate stories for each drawing, expressing themselves not with life experience, but with unbridled imagination.
So, I started off just doing a green line around here, and then I started colouring here.
Okay.
But I really like working with straight lines, so I sort of did a straight line there, and then I sort of just did round.
I used all of the different highlighters.
That's perfect. Well, okay, now flip it around.
Their journeys were just beginning. These two events leveled the playing field in a profound way that none of us saw coming. We had planned to be their guides. Now we were the students.
I like drawing like random sort of shapes and then coloring them in with different colors.
Me too, actually.
I felt like I had so much to learn from each of them.
We just have this weight of judgment that is constraining us in being able to be more creative, and it's just releasing that a little bit, not just through play, but just also the mindset of what we're bringing when we do play.
I bet there's a lot of dots. So to say you didn't do much is not quite true, because I've made dots before and that took a lot of work.
Yeah, it does take a long time.
Yes, it does.
And then you have to try and make sure they don't squeeze together.
Going into it being unsure what would happen, and in both situations, even though it's completely different groups of people, I saw nothing but happiness and joy in the experience through all of us, not just from the kids and the adults, but through us running the session.
I think it was an excellent experience in the fact that people that haven't ever picked up a pen before and done a pattern have had that experience later in life. They might never have thought they could produce a piece of artwork that everybody was just in awe of. And I think that's fantastic in itself.
I think about my own art and how it's changed over the course of my life already. I wonder where it will go and where my focus should be. After this experience, I know it's not possible to predict. No doubt we each have a lot to build on and a long way to go.
They were asking like what my job is. I said, well, my job is art, so I do this full time. In addition to making paintings, which is the art that I make, I travel around and get to talk to groups like you. We can come together and make art together.
All that it means to engage with the world creatively is to see what is around you, and instead of seeing it as just one thing, see it as many potential things.
Regardless of how things are turning out, regardless of what life is giving you, having that openness of what am I going to discover about myself, what
am I going to bring to the world, and just having that adventurous spirit.
The only way through life is forward.
I know, I think that was fantastic. Oh my god.
That was on point.
Yeah, that was.
Let's hope the audio is turned out.
Yeah, actually, I think it did.
Because.
The cat has an opinion.
Go away. Okay.
Okay.